We just finished talking about other tools in Photoshop. Now I want to show you something that helps you really refine a selection based on colors. And this is going to be the color range feature. The color range feature is really interesting because it's an engine that Photoshop has to make selections and picking colors and picking certain areas of an image much easier. So say the pen tool, or say a quick selection or a mask itself is getting hard to use in certain areas. The color range feature allows you to do that really simply. Let's get into Photoshop and work on the same image we did in the last section. We'll go to Select, Color Range. And when you have color range brought up, you have to make sure that first and foremost, you don't have your mask selected and the area that you want to select is visible. So ultimately, for this instance, we have just a background layer and that's all we really need. Once we have the background layer visible and that layer selected, we can then start using the color range feature. By default, you'll see the section on select called sample colors. What that means is it wants your input on what you want to select. Once you've selected a color, say for example his blue shirt, it generates a preview on the actual thumbnail. I can change the preview to replicate what's happening on the image itself. It's not going to affect your image, so don't worry. It's just giving you an overall preview of what's being selected. So if I select the background or the rocks, you can see that different tones are being selected across the image. And this is an example of what your mask is going to look like. So let's say I want his shirt selected, but it's not selecting every part of his shirt. You can increase the fuzziness range, which is a funny word for it, but it's basically like tolerance. It gives you more of a selection in this very similar area, which I think is really fascinating. And you can do the same for any other area as well. So let's say we have our sky selected. However, some bits of the face and the glasses are coming through. And that's not a problem. As long as we have something to work with, it gives us an opportunity to refine that further. So I'm going to hit OK. And you can see it makes that marching ants again. So I'll come back in the background and then use an adjustment layer. I'll stick to curves because that seems to be something that gives you quick impact. And you can see our exposure being either blowing it out or bringing back more detail. So let's say I increase the curve to add more exposure. What about those other parts that were selected in our image? How are they being affected? Well, visually, you can see that it's actually not being impacted that much. So you can get away with being not perfect. Although, if you want it to be perfect, the answer is quite simple. We'll option and click on the mask. We'll zoom in. And since this is showing through a little bit of white, either take our brush, use black, and fill it in. The best part is the fact that it makes really advanced selections quite simply. Doing this by hand would take forever. So aside from using your brush, like I mentioned before in the previous section, we'll go to our burn tool, which is going to darken, and we will darken our mask. And we'll quickly just go over that. Make sure exposure is 100% and go over it. The way this works is simple because most of these areas are considered approximately your midtones. You can see that the range is set to midtone, so only those are being affected. Most of us who use this technique will go over an area a few times till it goes away. If there's an area that doesn't go away, you can quickly just use your paintbrush and fill those in.